Hello, wonderful family. Another glorious day and another beautiful opportunity to share the word with you. Hallelujah. Praise God. Today, I want us to study again from this popular scripture, Isaiah chapter 45, noting certain pertinent things in it. Praise God. Praise God. We'll start from verse 1 from the King James Version. Thus saith the Lord to his anointed. And I like asking, are you his anointed? If you are his anointed, you know that the name Christian means the anointed ones. Thus said God, Jehovah, to Christians, to Cyrus, whose right hand I have holden. Now notice this. He says, I have holden. So if you're a Christian, he's telling you that he has upheld your right hand to do what? To subdue nations before him. So he's upheld your right hand to subdue nations before you. So you can confess that to yourself, that he has upheld his right hand to subdue nations before you, because you are his anointed. Then now notice how many statements of this word, I will. Sorry, I'm having some technical issues. Yeah, this word, I will. It's telling you of his will. Are you looking for God's will? What is God's will concerning certain matters? Now, pay attention. He says, before, and I will loose the loins of kings. So it is his will to loose the loins of kings. That is to give you access to kings, to give you favor with kings. It says, I will loose the loins of kings, to open before him the two lip gates. So this is favor, that things will not be shut unto you. Things will not be shut unto you. So to open, things will be open unto you, the two lip gates, and the gates shall not be shut. You get? Praise God. Now, notice another I will statement here. I will go before thee and make the crooked places straight. So it is his will to go ahead of you and straighten out crooked places. He says again, I will. So it is his will to break in pieces the gates of brass, those obstacles that have held you back. He goes and breaks them. It is his will to go and break them, and cut in sunder the bars of iron. And I will give thee, another I will statement, I will give thee the treasures of darkness. So it's not a matter of I might. So if you see, these are promises. And he says, I will give thee the treasures of darkness. So you can claim that promise for yourself as long as you are his anointed. Says, I will give thee the treasures of darkness and hidden riches of secret places, that thou mayest know that I, the Lord, which called thee by thy name, am the God of Israel. So the reason behind that is so that you will know that it is him doing it. But pay attention, that it is his will that these things be done. These are promises. So you see, the Bible, we get to understand that faith begins where the will of God is known. These are the I wills that tell you the will of God. So you can believe him for this. And faith is believed and spoken out. It is resident in your heart when you believe. And then because you have believed, you speak out. And that's your faith speaking that brings it into the here and now. So these are the I wills that you can use to shape your destiny, because Jehovah himself has promised, and faithful is he who promised. If you bring his promise back to him, he's honor bound to keep his word. Think about it. God bless you. Hallelujah.